Guys, what's going on? Welcome back to another episode of The Arsenio Buck Show. Guys, my voice is back. I am so happy that I am no longer plugged in with my sinuses. So guys, well, maybe just a little bit. But guys, today let's talk about, is there a shortcut to riches? Okay, so there's so many different opinions out there. First and foremost, I mean, we got the Gary Vee that says it takes a lot of hard work. Well, the thing is, I know a lot of people who work hard in warehouses and make dog shit minimum wage with dog shit ass bosses. I'm just keeping it real. I'm really keeping it real this morning, okay? Because if Gary, you know, just, there are some things, first and foremost, love Gary Vee. But there are some things that I'm just like, okay, I'm just going to either accept or reject the idea that, you know, hustling will make you rich. Well, the thing is, I know hustlers, well, I don't know hustlers, but there are hustlers on the streets of Chicago that actually deal drugs. There are hustlers at Walmart that get complete at Walmart. Of course, it's like one of the big, store brands and stuff out there that, that basically, oh man, I'm getting so many messages that it's crazy. But there are, it's just one of those main store brands out there that you could buy clothes and buy food and stuff like that. But you know what? In regards to that, how poorly are the employees mistreated by either the customers or that ridiculous ass boss that they have in just about every Walmart? How about, you know, like the dentist that I had? You know what? I used to hustle my ass off in the dental assistant office. And you know what? I was paid poorly and I was treated ridiculously bad. So, what is, of course, does hustling bring you riches? Absolutely not. What brings you riches and why do you want to become rich? So a lot of you out there, I mean, right now, if I asked you guys, if I gave you $1 million right now, would you accept it? Of course, a lot of you would say, yeah, but would that be the answer to all your problems? A lot of you would be like, yeah, I can actually pay my bills now. No, you could pay your bills now. Well, you can actually pay your bills right now if you want to. But the thing is, you don't know how to manage your money. You don't know how to do more than what you're paid for, and you don't have the habit of saving. So regardless, if you get that $1 million, like I said, and I wrote in my blog, unless you win the lottery, you're still going to end up broke. Because you're broke within the mind. You know what? My brother commented on this guy becoming rich all of a sudden. And I remember my brother was still just the same old sorry ass nigga. Excuse my language. But you know what? I'm just going to break it down like this. My brother actually posted a video on his Facebook probably about 2 years ago. The last time I ever spoke to him and the last time I ever will speak to him. And he was talking about, he posted, of course, in the comment. He said, he's just keeping it real. And I watched the video, and it was this news anchor. She was interviewing this guy that actually won the Monster Ball, the Lotto Ball, something like that. He won $170 million U.S. dollars. And the guy wasn't even happy whatsoever. He was just filling out the information, and she was like, what are you going to do with the money? He's like, I'm going to buy cocaine. Of course. You cannot, guys, all it is, if I give you the money, if I give you the rich, and you haven't changed the paradigm within the mind, you're still the same old person. How many people have gone broke after getting all of that money? Let's talk about Shaquille O'Neal in terms of riches. Shaquille O'Neal, being the fool he was, he got $1 million. I forgot when it was, but he actually signed a contract. He was awarded $1 million when he was coming out of college, LSU, into the Orlando Magic. I think this was 1994 or 1995. Shaquille O'Neal, he said he spent $1 million in one day. He went out, he wanted to hurry up and get a Mercedes-Benz because that's all what he wanted, $150,000 gone. He went back home, of course, his father, not having the paradigm, of course, before and after he received that $1 million. Of course, I'm referring to his son, Shaquille O'Neal. And his father was like, hey, I want one too. Went back to the dealership. I want another one. That's $300,000 gone. His mother wanted one. Oh, I want one too, but you know what? I want a smaller one. Boom, there goes $450,000. And there were, of course, a couple other things like the jewelry, the stupid watches, the stupid this, the stupid that. And all of that money was gone within an instant. So, guys, is there a shortcut to riches? No. First, I really do strongly advise all of you to change your mind before you become rich. Because if you don't change your mind, you're going to end up spending all that money on materialistic shit that you've always wanted, only to realize that none of that was going to change you and change your viewpoint, perception, point of view, whatever you want to call it, on life. You're still going to be the same old person. You know what? I mean, love my mom dearly. Love her to death. You know, me and my mom, she congratulated me on getting a proposed principal position out of school, which I am unbelievably grateful for. I'm not sure if I'm going to take the position. I'll probably do a lesser position in terms of, like, recruitment, hiring manager, and other things like that. But just being able to be offered a principal position at a school is just remarkable. Can I take up that job? Not necessarily. It's not in alignment with what I want to do with my life, but there are other things that I could do in terms of helping that specific individual start an international school. But my mom congratulated me, and I love my mom so dearly. But there was a moment, of course, back in 2013 that my mom asked me for $100 US, and I was only making $600 US a month at that time. The transfer fee would have been $50 US, and the thing is, I would have been out of, what is that? Probably, yeah, about 25% of my monthly income if I would have given my mother that $100 US at that time to fix her car. And so my mom, about 3 years later, I realized that she bought a new Dodge Dart. A Dodge Dart. That is basically a 2016. That's a specific model of course, the Dodge. And I'm like, okay, just 3 years prior to that, you didn't have $100 US in your name. And now you bought another car at the cusp of 60 years old with no retirement set up. See, guys, the thing is, again, I'm going to refer back to it. If you become rich and you don't change your mind, you're still poor. And you know what? I hope that point hits home with a lot of you. Because until, honestly, am I ready to become rich right now? Not necessarily. And honestly, do I want to become rich? Hell no, I don't give a damn. I just care about my life assignment, life work, and doing what I love to do every single day. If that's making 100,000 baht a month, if that's making $10,000 US a month or $20,000 US a month, so be it. As long as I'm reaching out to places that are in need of help, I want to inspire, I want to instill the knowledge that I've gained in human beings all across the planet. And if that's making whatever money I do make at that specific moment, then so be it. But the thing is, it's not so much about being a shortcut and having a shortcut and finding a shortcut to becoming rich. I want to become rich and pose in front of a Lamborghini. And oh yes, I want to show everyone that I'm just so, I am saturated with all this money. I'm posing with all these people. Oh, I get to eat meat Tai Lopez and all these ridiculous ass pseudo entrepreneurs who are after the money and not after changing people's lives. They are never going to be fulfilled. This is why Kate Spade, Anthony Bourdain, this is why so many people have ended up taking their lives, because they were not truly fulfilled. Why? Money, 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 money. But what else is it that you're trying to achieve? Once you achieve the money, then what? Boom. See? That's when people fall into a hole. That's when people become complacent. That's when people realize, oh, you know what? I'm not even doing this. I'm not doing that. See, Anthony Bourdain, from the very, very beginning, all those places that he traveled to, he could have left a very profound mark within those places and say, you know what, I need to set up something. I see that this is happening. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. There was one episode with Anthony Bourdain. He was actually eating a plate of food while 150 Haitians watched him eat that food. He felt bad. He ended up giving them the food. They ended up ransacking all the food, et cetera, et cetera. The thing is, see, I would have said right at that moment, you know what, this is unfair. This is ridiculous. How can we get these people food on a consistent basis? See what I mean? I'm telling you, man, that's called being rich. You know what? I actually wrote an essay during my high school proficiency exam back in my 11th grade of high school. And it said, is there such thing being rich in terms of not having money? And I ended up almost having a perfect score on that essay because I was like, okay, Michael Jordan. Yes, Michael Jordan. He has created such a brand. He is rich. He has all the money in the world. But what has he actually done for the people? How many people have died? How many African-American children have died in the name of Michael Jordan because they wanted those Jordans that that specific individual had on his feet at that specific moment? They pulled a gun out and said, give me your shoes. I want those Jordans. He said, no, he killed them. How many people have died? And he says, oh, you know what? It's not my fault. It is your fault because you release an unlimited edition amount every year. And it's unfair because what are you doing? You are inadvertently getting Black American, African American children killed. And so guys, rich, what does rich mean? Ask yourself that. And do you want to become that at your present state of mind right now? Because Anthony Bourdain was rich. Michael Jordan's rich. But what is he actually doing? Oh, well, he's creating charities and this. Yeah, to create brand. But what is he actually doing in terms of helping other? Is he setting up academies? Oh, maybe he is. Oh, I don't give a damn. Are you doing it for the better of humanity? What is the Jeff Bezos doing? See, that's why I appreciate Bill Gates so much, because I actually see him doing a lot in terms of getting clean water, in terms of developing cures, in terms of investing in companies that are probably on the cusp of achieving greatness and this and that. That's why I appreciate him. But what is Jeff Bezos doing? What is Mark Zuckerberg? Oh, Mark Zuckerberg actually have some life work too. So what are you doing to become rich in the name of your legacy? That's what rich is. Has nothing to do with finances. Now, finances will, of course, encourage you and push you forward in terms of becoming rich in a certain aspect. But what are you pushing for your society to do? There is no shortcut. And that shortcut, it's called the journey. And when you embellow yourself and you accept that journey and you love that journey, basically what I had to go through at this beginning of the year up until this specific moment, that's actually the journey. So it's not the shortcut. Is there a shortcut to the riches? No, there's a journey to becoming rich. And I'm not talking about finance. I'm talking about legacy. So guys, keep that in mind today. We got some good stuff coming up tomorrow in terms of the citadel of rich and all this other stuff. I'm going to break down everything that Napoleon Hill said in his book. I'm going to try to give back to you guys as much as possible, as always. And of course, this is your host, baby. If you guys love this podcast, please share it. If you shared it, that means you liked it. And I do what I do. And I mean, I am so grateful for all the comments. And thank you so much for Amsterdam. You guys have given me probably 13% of my podcast plays on SoundCloud alone. 13% in 2 days compared to what I've gotten in 2 years. So I do want to extend my outreach and my gratitude out to, of course, my Dutch out there in the Netherlands. Thank you so much. Again, guys, there are so many great things that are going to be coming up very soon. So as always, man, this is your host, Radiating Positivity, all the goddamn time, Arsenio Buck, over and out.